हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी यूनिट नंबर 6, मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट पॉलिसीज। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल कवर स्वैपिंग एंड डिमांड पेजिंग, द टू कॉन्सेप्ट स्वैपिंग एंड डिमांड पेजिंग। फर्स्ट व्हाट वी विल सी, मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट सबसिस्टम। द मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट सबसिस्टम डिसाइड्स व्हिच प्रोसेस शुड रेसिड इन मेन मेमोरी। Here it is very simple. The purpose of memory management subsystem is to decide which process will reside in main memory and which will reside on the swap space. It's like a manager. Memory management unit acts like a memory management subsystem acts like a manager. It manages the space on primary memory. It monitors the amount of available primary memory and periodically write process to the secondary memory device called as the swap device to provide more space in primary memory. This memory management subsystem acts like a monitor. It just monitors the availability of amount of available memory in primary memory, and periodically write processes to secondary memory device called as a swap device to provide more swap space in primary memory. It simply monitors the primary memory and periodically writes the data or processes to the secondary device that is called a swap device so that it can create space on the primary memory. Now let us see what is swap device. Swap device is a block device in a configurable section of a disk. Swap device is a block device as it is part of hard disk, and hard disk is a block device. So swap device is a block device. Now let us see swapping. Unix system transferred entire processes between primary memory and the swap device. Unix system transfers complete process from primary memory to the swap device. It is easier to implement. It has less system overhead. Here we will discuss these three things: manage swap space, managing space on the swap device, swapping process out of memory, swapping process into memory. We will cover these things. First thing, managing space on the swap device. Second, swapping process out of memory. And last one is a swapping process into main memory. These three things we will discuss. Now we will discuss the allocation of swap space. We have swap device and there is some space available on the swap space. Here, to allocate a file, swap device allocate group of contiguous blocks. It allocates contiguous blocks, while on other side kernel allocates one block at a time. And for the swap device, map used is as a data structure. A data structure used is a map, and for other case it is a linked list. Now let us see map. What is map? Map plays an important role in allocation of swap space. Map is an array where each consists of an address of allocatable resources and the number of resource units available. Initially, a map contains one entry that indicates the address and the total number of space available. Let us take this. Address is 1 and total number of units are available 10,000. It's the initial swap map. And let us map this with the definition. See, this address of an allocatable resources. That is the address and the number of resources units. That is the 10,000 units are available. Okay, it means this is a map entry. The map has address of allocated resource and number of units available. Here in this example, address is 1 and total number of units available are 10,000. Now let us go through this algorithm for allocating swap space from the maps. Now the name of the algorithm is malloc. There are two inputs. First input is a map address and requested number of units. Map address means to find the exact location where we can allocate it, and second is total number of units required, requested units. Output is address. It will provide address. If this algorithm executes successfully, we will get address, otherwise zero. Now let us see, for every map entry, if current map entry can fit requested units, see our requested number of units, it will check every map entry. It will check every map entry using for loop. If current map entry can fit requested units, suppose we have one map entry and which fits current requested number of units, and if requested units equal to number of units in entry, first case what will say, current map entry can fit requested units, first thing, and second thing, if requested units equal to number of units in the entry, okay, then it will delete entry from the map. It will delete an entry, that entry from the map. Otherwise, if this is not the case, then address the start address of the entry and return original address of entry. It means the number of requested units are less than this total number of entries available, then it will address the start address of entry. Then it will return the original address of entry. Otherwise, if this will not happen, then it will return 0. It will return 0 means this algorithm failed. There is no space available. Now let us see allocation. Now let us see the allocation of a swap space. Here we have address 1, starting address 1, and total number of units available are 10,000. Total number of units are available 10,000. Allocate 100 units. We have to allocate 100 units. First, now it will become 101 as we allocated from 1 onwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. It will reach up to 101. It means total number of units available are 9,900. Means we allocated 100 units. It means now we can allocate from 101 as we allocated 100 units. So its initial address will become 101. Now if we again allocate 50 units, then from 101 we allocate next 50 units. So the address will become 151 and remaining units will become 9,850. Suppose again after that, again if we allocate 100 units, then the address will become 251 and total number of units available will become 9,750, because this we add 100 to 151, it will become 251, and we will subtract 100 from this 9,850, it will become 9,750. Okay, in this way, swap space can be allocated. Now, how to find a proper position when freeing resource? There are three ways. Completely fill a hole in the map. Combine the newly freed resources and the existing two entries in the map. First thing. Second, partially fill a hole in the map. Partially fill a hole in the map where if precedes are contiguous with the map entry but not both, that adjust the address and it fits. Last one, partially fill a hole but are not contiguous to the any resources in the map. Here in this case, create a new entry for the map and insert it in the proper position. Now let us free. address. Here our address is 251 and total number of units available are 9750. Now here in this example, here we'll free 50 units at address 101. What is our task? Our task is to free 50 units at address 101. Okay, so there will be availability of two entries in map. There are two entries. First entry 101 address and two second entries 251 second address. It means we can say that at 101 50 units are available, and from address 251 we have 9750 units are available. Okay, now suppose again we free 100 units at address 1. Yes, if we free 100 units at address 1, so this first entry will be modified and it will become 1 and it will run up to 150. It means total units available are 150. Starting address will become 1 and total number of units available will become 150. And second entry as it is 251 starting address and total number of units are available, that is 9750. It means we have two holes. First hole is of 150 and second hole is of 9750. Now we'll see, we'll allocate swap space from the second entry. Now suppose 200 units to be allocated. We have two entries. First entry address 1, 150 units available. Second entry 251 starting address and number of units available are 9750. If we allocate 200 units. Now, is it possible to allocate this first hole? No, it is not possible, as the number of units available are 150. We cannot allocate 150 units. So, it is necessary to use this second entry. We can use this entry if number of units are less than 150 or equal to 150. Then we can use this entry. But we need to allocate 200 units. So we'll use second entry. So it will become 451 and number of units available becomes 9550. Now we'll stop here and we'll see in next video.